we see the male rider on a horse, if you look at his pelvis, how high his pubic symphysis is, then his seat bones. Here we see the four curves we have as a rider. The male has a longer tailbone. His gluteus medius is closer to the horse. His lower back is not as curved. The saddle tree comes down in the front, very close to the horse here, and then comes up. So the rider, the male rider, sits very close to the horse. And when we look at the difference between the space we have right here between the male and female, we can see not only is the pubic symphysis very high and the seat bone very close, but also because his lower back is not as curved and his tailbone and his gluteus medius is lower, the male rider has much more support in the back seat. Here we see a female on a horse, way more curve in the lower back, tailbone much shorter. Because of the curve in the lower curvature in the shorter tailbone, the gluteus medius is higher, and you see much more space in the back of the bottom right there. Here we see lower pubic symphysis, her front seat bone comes in first, and then the seat bone goes up. Lower curve much stronger, shorter tailbone, gluteus medius higher. So on a common male saddle, she would hit in the front and would have no support in the back, and she would slouch, fall into a chair seat where her leg will go then forward, and she has no support.